Hello web accessibility heroes. Today we will make the hamburger menus web accessible. Hamburger menus or vertical sliding menus are commonly used for cell phones and tablet designs. This sleek design is adopted by almost all the organizations, and developers have done great work with respect to the animations and the sliding transition effects. But they miss one key element, and that is the web accessibility for hamburgers. Today, we will add that last piece to make sure that the non-sighted users can also access the hamburgers as their sighted peers. If you are new to this channel, I'm Singh, and on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications and share awesome UI and ADA tips. Now, if you like this style of videos, then please do me a favor by subscribing to this channel and smash that thumbs up button to help other developers implement web accessibility. Now let's cover what a web accessible hamburger must have. First, a user must be able to access the hamburger menu and the menu items using keyboard keys only. A user must be informed how many menu items are available and his or her current position. Third, a user should be able to close the menu and get back to the hamburger menu only by using the keyboard keys. Last but not the least, there should be 0x DevTool errors. This includes color contrast as well. Now let's code together to make hamburger web accessible. You can find the complete code source on my GitHub. When you search for site navigation or hamburgers online, you'll find W3 schools having some of the explanations. These are the different options that they have for the site navbar. When you click on these, you will get to see what kind of transitions they have. This sleek design is actually used by most of the organizations, and for today's video, we will focus on making this light navbar or hamburger menu web accessible. Let's close this. Let's get the HTML that we need. Let's copy this div along with this span. Come back to our HTML. We'll save this. If I go back to our browser, we have this open button, but this is not clickable because we don't have the JavaScript for it. Let's go back to W3 Schools portal. I've already taken care of the CSS. Let's go ahead for the JavaScript. So these two functions we need to add in our scripts. So immediately before my body ends, I'll create a script tag. Within this, we can have this functions. Let's fix the indentation. Let's save this. Now let's come back to our browser. We have this open text, which is coming from this pen. When I click on it, it opens up this site navbar, and for a visual user, this is looking good, but there are few concerns from accessibility standpoint, and let's cover them one by one. First thing first, when I start tabbing, I'm unsure of where my tab is. So if you can see, nothing is getting focused on the browser, even though I'm pressing tab keys multiple times. Those are the things we need to fix, and we should follow the correct HTML5 semantics. Now let's go ahead and start making hamburger or site navbar web accessible. First of all, let's have a traditional hamburger icon, and that should be within a button rather than a span. Let's follow the correct HTML5 semantics. So what I'll do is, within this section, I'll create a button whose type will be button, because we don't want it to be a form submit. Next, we can have a class. We'll say btn-success, btn primary, and to this we will be using font awesome icons, which I have already opened up. You can use this library to get the awesome icons that they have. So let's copy this and let's put it here. I'll save this. If we go back to our browser, we have this button, which is looking better than simply an open text. I'll be using some of the classes like btn open menu. Let's copy this. Go back to our button section. Instead of button-success, let's give btn-open menu. Next, let's delete this span, which we don't need anymore. Now let's change this div into a navbar structure. Let me go ahead and change this div into nav. Next, we have to make sure that these hyperlinks are within the ordered list or unordered list. In our case, we can use unordered list because we are not following certain steps. These are different links or different menu items that the user can access. Let's create a UL tag on order list. Within this, we'll have the li tags, and each li tag will have the hyperlink. So let's create 4 different li tags, and let's start putting the hyperlinks that we have. Go back to our button, and within this we can say on click, we'll be calling this function a JavaScript function. If you go back to our browser, when I click on it, it opens up the menu. Next, we need to make sure that this navbar is web accessible as well. We have taken care of the HTML5 semantics, but we need to add more so that assistive technologies such as JAWS should be able to recognize the different menu items and the details within them. So first thing first, we will add an aria label to the navbar. We'll say aria-label menu. And similarly for this hyperlink, which is actually your close button within this nav side nav, right? Let's put it in the next line. What we want to do is we want to add a meaningful alternate text, which will be read by the assistive technologies. We'll say aria label for this, and we can say close main menu. Next, we need to start adding the aria attributes to the unordered list. Let's give an ID to this ordered list. I'll say ID equals to menu bar 1 for now. Next, we have to give a role, and role should be menu bar, because this represents the menu bar in our application. And then next, we have to give role of none to the li items. And the reason for that is we want to give role of menu item to the actual hyperlink, so that it makes more sense for the assistive technologies. Let's do the same for all the li tags. Let's copy this role. I'll put it for all the li tags here. And then I'll copy this role from this hyperlink for all the hyperlinks that we have in our menu bar. Let's go ahead and add some aria label. So we'll say aria label open main menu. So when JAWS is running, it will read open main menu button. And then if we look for the side navbar, if this is having aria label, and if I expand this, we have this button which is having aria label as close main menu. And then finally, we have the unordered list, which is having role as menu bar, along with list items which are having a role as none, followed by the actual links which are having role as menu item. Next thing we need to make sure is that the user is aware whether this button is in the expanded state or in the collapsed state. And for that, we have an aria attribute as aria expanded. So we can use that here. We'll say aria expanded, and we can set it to false, because by default, it's always in the closed state when your page loads. And we can use JavaScript or jQuery to toggle the value of aria expanded attribute. Now let's change the options that we have in our hamburger menu. We'll change it from about to, we'll say home, and we can use Font Awesome's icons. So let's copy this, and after home we'll add it, and then we can change services to products. And this can be whatever application that you're working on, you can make those changes accordingly. So let's quickly do that. And then we have contact us will be using this phone icon. And then finally we'll have a gallery, and for gallery we can use these images. Let's save this, go back to our browser, open it, and verify we have all these details. Now, we messed up, we should have all these icons at the beginning. So let me put it here. Let's add some space. Let's do it for contact us, and then finally gallery. Let's save this. Now all our icons should be at the beginning of the menu items. Next, what we need to do is we need to add another attribute to these icons that we added, we should add aria-hidden so that they say these are not read by the assistive technologies. So we'll say aria-hidden, set it value to true. Let's copy this and do it for the other icons that we have in our application. Now I think it's high time that we go ahead and make some changes to our JavaScript so that we can toggle the attributes such as aria expanded false to true whenever the navbar is in the open state. Before we do that, I will replace this style by the class that I have added in our code. So I have the active menu class which is having width of 250. So we'll be using this in our JavaScript. Let's get rid of this. And what we want to do is we want to add the active menu class to this side navbar section. So first we have to find the element. So if you scroll up, we have this as the main navigation, which is having my site nav as the ID. Let's copy this and put it here. And to this we want to add a class. So let's go back to our CSS and look for that class. Let's copy the name, come back to our JavaScript and add it. And when I click on it, it's adding the class that we just added to the mysadnav. Now there is one more thing that we need to do. So when I start tabbing, it's actually tabbing to the elements which are not seen on the page. What I meant by that is if I inspect this element, we have this navbar which is having the links which are having hrefs, which is making them tabbable. And if we want to verify that, let's do document.activeElement. So currently my focus was on the button. So let me tab again, tab one more time, do it twice. I'll come back to our console, press enter. See, my focus is going to the anchor tag, which is not even displayed on the page, which is a bad user experience for the persons who are using keyboard keys, and mostly they are the non-sighted users. So what we want to do is we want to hide those links which are not available or which are not seen on the page. And that we can do is putting a class to this unordered list. We'll say play none, which will not be displayed or which will be hidden from the end users. Now if we start tabbing, my focus is on this button. Now let's do document.activeElement. It says my focus is on the button. Let me do it tab again. Now if I do this, my focus is on the body, which is fine because my focus is staying within the browser, which is in the open state. Now there is this issue. Once you click on this, your details will not be displayed. And for that, we have to toggle this class or this unordered list. Let's fix the indentation here. Let's find that element. And what we want to do is we want to remove the class, which is display none. Let's save this. Let's go back to our browser, click on it, and we have the details. Next, we have to make sure that the area attribute area expanded for this button is changing when it's in the open state. Let's go back to our open function again. Let's say find my open menu button. And then we have to change the attribute. And what value we want to update is, or what attribute we want to update is area expanded. Let's copy this and set this value to true. So if we save this, go back to our browser, let's do an inspect element. Let's find this button first. So this button is having area expanded as false. And when you click on it, it's changing to area expanded equals to true. Next, what we want to do is when we click on this menu, our focus should move to the first element or to the X button here, the close button. And for that, we have to simply use a focus function. So let's find this element. In our case, it is actually having a class close button. So let's find this close button and we want to put focus to this close button. Let's save this, open this one. Close button is actually having the focus when the slide navbar opens. And when you start tabbing, it goes to the next element. Now we have done it for the open navbar. Let's copy this entire thing and come back to our close navbar function. Let's delete this one and paste what we copied there. Now what we want to change here is when we are closing this navbar, we have to remove this class instead of adding the class. Let's go ahead and make those modifications. We'll say remove class. Next, we want to add a class display none to the unordered list. And then for this hamburger, we want to set the area expanded to false. And this hamburger should get the focus when the side navbar is in the closed state. So let's change it for the BTN open menu. Let's refresh our browser. I'll be using tab key to move focus to my hamburger. When I click on it, it's opening up my side navbar and my focus is moving to the first element, which is the close button. Now I'm using my tab keys to move through all the elements that are there. And when I press enter, when my focus is on the close button, it closes the side navbar and my focus moves to the hamburger menu. And again, if I press spacebar, it should open up the side navbar. There is one last piece that we want to add, and that is user should be able to close the side navbar by pressing the escape key. And that we can achieve by writing a very simple JavaScript. We need to find the key up event which happens on the document itself. We'll say a document dot key up event, and on this we want to trigger a function. Let's give e here. We want to find the event that happened. Next, we need to add some conditions here. We need to find whether this section is actually having the class active menu, so that we are aware that the menu bar is in the open state. Well, let's copy the entire code here, and instead of add class, we need to check if this section is having a class. So we will be using a function, jQuery's function has class. If it returns true, we need to do something. And what we need to do next is we need to find what was the key that was pressed by the users. And we'll say e dot key is equals to escape. Put it here and save it. I'll be using keyboard keys only. Let's press enter to open up. Press tab, goes into the menus, press escape key, it closes it. And my focus moves back to the hamburger menu. Let's press enter again. And this time without going into the options, let's press escape key and it's closing. This is how we can achieve web accessibility for a hamburger menu or the slide navbar. Now our code is ready for us to go ahead and run JAWS to see what it announces.
Hamburger menu. Main region. Open main menu button collapsed. To activate, press space bar. Space. Main menu navigation region. Close main menu link. Menu. Home. 1 of 4. To move through items, press up or down arrow. Products current page. 2 of 4. Contact us. 3 of 4. Gallery. 4 of 4. Escape. Leaving menus. Open main menu button collapsed. To activate, press spacebar.
See, it's that easy to make HTML hamburgers web accessible. And in case you want to level up accessibility for drop-down menus, watch this video. Please comment if you are using horizontal or a vertical menu in your website. See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.